and welcome to Mountaineer Field, where we've got a hot one for you this evening. Gus Johnson, along with Charles Davis, my partner, and welcome to Morgantown and CD. Tonight, we'll get a chance to see two of the top quarterbacks in all of America.
And dare we say, the Heisman Trophy frontrunners. And let's start with West Virginia and Geno Smith, who's been scintillating all season long. Yes, they had a little bit of an off game last week at Texas Tech. They're looking for redemption tonight. We know Geno Smith is a tactician and a general from the pocket. But tonight, I'd like to see him use his legs a little bit more to keep drives alive and to sting the defense. That will create even more throwing lanes for his dangerous receivers.
Meanwhile, for Kansas State, Al Davis would love Colin Klein. Just win, baby, win.
That's all he does. And we know he's going to use his legs first. He is Optimus Klein, the big, strong quarterback who does keep drives alive running the football. But as soon as you play him strictly for the run, he'll go play action and hit you deep. So you've got to be very careful with that. The motion in throwing the football is not pretty, but the results, they're gorgeous.
So Colin Klein, undefeated, his team ranked fourth in the nation, ready to take the field here in Morgantown. And already, folks, tempers flaring. Kansas State tried to huddle up on the West Virginia WV, and things got heated in a hurry.
Let's go win on three. One, two, three.
Win.
Go hard, baby. Go hard all day.
Take care of the ball. Great leadership. Lead the win on three. One, two, three.
Lead the win.
You only got one motto, and that's win.
Get ready to rumble.
Mountaineer Field, Morgantown, West Virginia. This is Fox College Football, presented by Geico. Where tonight, Bill Snyder brings his Kansas State Wildcats into Morgantown to take on the Mountaineers. It's number 4 versus number 13 on FOX. Gus Johnson along with Charles Davis. Beautiful night here in Morgantown. And we're ready for football. Time now to join the third member of our team on the sideline. Here's Julie Alexandria.
Thanks, Gus. You know, you guys mentioned Geno Smith a little bit earlier, and I got a chance to talk to Coach Holgorsen about his quarterback earlier today, and he said it's go time for Geno. This is why he's here. He's got to play within the framework, but he's also got to make big plays. He's got to keep that drive alive. He's got to stay confident, and he's got to take control early. This is why he's here. National stage tonight. This is a must win for them. Guys?
All right. Thank you very much, Julie. And a good football weather this evening. 50 degrees at kickoff time. Rain may come a little later on, but right now it's all clear as Big 12 football continues here on Fox as we take a look at the BCS top 10 teams and what they did today.
And we see Florida jumped on South Carolina in a big game there. Notre Dame survived, and we thought there might be a little letdown after the win against Stanford, but they survived against BYU, and LSU had to come back from 12 down to win at Texas A&M. So those teams continue to move on and still keep themselves in a position to be considered at the end of the year for the BCS National Championship game.
So Dana Holgorsen, the head coach of this Mountaineer team, he's looking for his squad to bounce back after a disappointing road loss last week at Texas Tech. West Virginia won the toss, deferred. So Kansas State will receive Bill Snyder, the legend, 73 years old now. He turned 73 2 weeks ago. And we are ready for college football on Fox. West Virginia and Kansas State. Tyler Lockett, Tremaine Thompson back deep for the Wildcats. And Corey Smith will send it away. ...60,000 strong, sellout crowd, and we're underway for Morgantown. This one fielded inside the 5. Tremaine Thompson up the sideline. Thompson sprinting. Thompson all the way up to midfield, and more. Corey Smith, the kicker, had to stop him, and it's a 49-yard return. And that brings us to this evening's Taco Bell Impact Player.
We take a look for Kansas State. John Hubert, the running back, a complimentary piece to Colin Klein running the football. Meshack Williams is their best pass rusher, and Arthur Brown, their best player on defense, and All-American in the middle. For West Virginia, Stedman Bailey has a gimpy ankle and foot. We'll see if he can go tonight. Josh Francis, the best pass rusher for West Virginia, and Carl Joseph, the freshman free safety, is a playmaking hitter in the secondary.
Thompson stepping out of bounds at the 43. That's where Kansas State starts. John Hubert. He'll pick up 2 yards on the play as he's stopped by Doug Rigg. So Colin Klein, 2012 All-America candidate and Heisman candidate, 17-4 as a starting quarterback at Kansas State.
And look at how he has picked up in the passing game this year. The completion percentage, a decided jump from last season, as is the yardage. He worked awfully hard in the offseason on his mechanics and motion, and his confidence is at an all-time high throwing the football.
Last week in their win against Iowa State, he was 16 of 24, 187 yards. No touchdowns, no picks. Hubert trying to bounce it outside, almost tracked down, continues to move forward as Darwin Cook comes up with the tackle.
And that play should have been so much better for West Virginia's defense, shouldn't it, partner? Did you see how they had him trapped in the backfield? And Hubert, hard to get a direct shot on, danced out of it and got something out of nothing.
22 carries, 79 yards for Hubert 1 week ago against Iowa State. Third down and 5 at the 48, opening drive for the Wildcats. Here's Klein to throw it. Klein over the middle. And caught. Lockett with the reception. A big first down, gain of 31 yards for Kansas State.
So important for West Virginia to come out here. Look, you said they deferred, right, on the opening kickoff? The defense needed to make a play, get off the field on third down for confidence. It doesn't happen. Instead, they get hit deep right off the bat on a key third down, and Kansas State's in business.
So first down and 10 now for Kansas State at the West Virginia 21-yard line. John Hubert, the single setback. Here's Hubert running left this time. And Hubert pushes the pile forward. He'll pick up 2.5, 3 yards on the play.
West Virginia's felt good all year long about their run defense. They think that's the best part of a defense that's been much maligned. But they have not played a team this season that's as committed to the run as Kansas State. You saw John Hubert's numbers there. Between him and Colin Klein, a 1-2 punch that they'll see for 4 quarters coming at them.
West Virginia giving up 131 yards on the ground, 43rd in the nation, 2nd and 7. Hubert again, skipping. Ooh, Hubert. What a collision. He gains 4 yards the hard way. Looks like he did pick up the first down. And looks like Darwin Cook came up and made the tackle.
See, Joe DeForest, the defensive coordinator in his first year at West Virginia, came from Oklahoma State, a special teams guru. And we had a chance to meet with him, and boy, it's been tough. Trying to preach the effort and the attitude and the toughness. Wants his team to mirror Kansas State. First and foremost, they want to get off the field on this drive.
So it's 3rd down and 3 at the 15. Here's Klein, trying to get outside, and no goal. Great pursuit, Josh Francis. Kansas State lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's the kind of play West Virginia's looking for from their defense. Josh Francis, an active and fast defender, ran down Colin Klein and did not allow him to cut back with power into the middle of the field. Or excuse me, at the corner of the field and turn it up.
So that brings on Anthony Cantelli in to attempt a 33-yarder. Last week he was 2 for 2, and he gets off to a good start here. So Colin Klein and Kansas State putting 3 points on the board. Coming up, Geno Smith will get his opportunity to lead West Virginia. A successful opening drive for Colin Klein at Kansas State. 7 plays, 41 yards, eating up 3:35. Cantelli with the 33-yard field goal.
It's counterintuitive, as it's also a successful drive for West Virginia. Why? They only gave up 3 points instead of 6. That's the way the game's played in the Big 12 now. You limit them to field goals and field goal attempts, you feel better about your chances with your own offense.
Geno Smith, the young man from Miami, Florida, ready to hit the field. As Cantelli will send it away, Tavon Austin and Jordan Thompson back deep. And folks, if you haven't seen Tavon Austin, number one, you're in for a treat. This kid is special. And he will take a knee in the end zone. So West Virginia will start from the 25. Here comes Geno. Number one in the nation in touchdown passes, passing percentage and passing efficiency. Last week against Texas Tech, 30 of 56, 278, a touchdown, and didn't have his best game.
You're looking at numbers there that many quarterbacks in the country would be high-fiving their coaches in film sessions. For Geno Smith, it felt like a disaster.
First down and 10 of the 25. Smith out of the shotgun. And he hands it off, Andrew Bowie. And Bowie knocked backwards by guess who? Arthur Brown Jr., senior from Wichita, Kansas, Miami transfer. And he is one of the most rugged defenders in the nation.
He is so sudden. I mean, a change of direction, and once he goes, you saw the end result. Finished off the play in a hurry.
A loss of 2, second down and 12 of the 23. Bowie in the backfield. Here's Smith, gives it to him. Whoa, what a big hole. Bowie exploding through the hole and he'll pick up the first down. Jared Milo stops him. But that West Virginia offensive line opening up a canyon.
And that was the left side with Quentin Spain at left tackle, 67. Josh Jenkins, 77, left guard. And Joe Madsen, the center, 74. Last week, Spain came under a lot of scrutiny for so-called tipping plays with his offensive stance. Nothing tipped on that play, just successful.
Remember, Bowie had a career-high 207 yards against Texas. And they find Tavon Austin, and he'll get 9. Tavon Austin from Baltimore Dunbar High School. He's a poet, and he is definitely a man that has shown some poetry on the field with this spectacular play. Second and short. They need a yard at the 45. Play fake. Smith trying to set up a screen. Incomplete. Who is the intended receiver?
Kansas State's a team that's very difficult to screen against. You know why? Because their defensive linemen are very intelligent in recognizing the signs of a screen. Did you notice who the first player was in the vicinity of it? It was number 92, Vilatui, defensive tackle. Recognized the play, figured it out, and was chasing the play down from the backside.
Third down conversion, sixth in the Big 12 for West Virginia, 51%. Third down and one of the 45. Smith under center this time. And he'll call a timeout. 9:52 to play in the first quarter. Back to Morgantown right after this. Fox College Football is sponsored by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And welcome back to Morgantown. Opening drive for Geno Smith and the Mountaineers. 262 straight pass attempts without an interception. He's chasing Trent Dilfer's record.
And that's in a single season. Had a chance to talk with Trent. He worked with Geno in the Elite 11 this offseason. Absolutely loves Geno Smith and wishes him the best of luck breaking his record.
Third down and one at the 45. Andrew Bowie, the deep man.
Showing the power set, but they have one-on-one up at the top and the bottom in coverage.
Here's Bowie looking for the first down. He won't get it. Great pressure by Kansas State. Arthur Brown Jr., first man to him.
And you know what that means? If he's the first guy, that means these guys up front handled their business. In other words, they kept him clean so he could run through. And what he did was he ran through the block of number 88, Cody Clay, the lead fullback. Played it perfectly. Look at the leverage. Low man wins, proper shoulder underneath, knocks him aside, and tackles the ball carrier.
So West Virginia punting it away. And back deep, Tremaine Thompson. Tyler Bittencourt, the punter. This one wobbly. And will be down inside the 10. A 48-yard punt. So Colin Klein back on the field. His team with a 3-0 lead. Welcome back. Now it's time to check out the Nissan Heisman Watch.
Well, we've got two of the top prospects here tonight in Geno Smith for West Virginia, Colin Klein for Kansas State. Manti Te'o's Notre Dame team stayed undefeated. He had another interception today. And Jordan Poyer from Oregon State has been playing very well as of late. Interceptions in each of his last three games. They have a big win against Utah later this evening.
Geno Smith and the Mountaineer offense coming up empty on their first drive. Now Colin Klein starts deep in his own territory. First down and 10 at the 8. Wilson and Hubert line up. In the offset eye, Klein audibly at the line of scrimmage. Here's Klein, wants to run it. And Klein picks up a yard. Kyle Rose, the redshirt freshman from Centerville, Ohio, making the tackle.
Keep an eye on what West Virginia does versus this Kansas State running game. They're going to show their regular sets, but as it goes closer to the snap count, watch how many more guys get into the box area to try and reduce Kansas State's options running the football inside. And I think they're going to run a lot of run blitzes tonight to try and cover up holes.
Second and 9 at the 9. Klein, play action. With time to the sideline. And throws it on the money. Terrific throw and catch. Chris Harper with the reception, the senior from Wichita.
Look at this. Look at what West Virginia's doing and the number of people close to the line of scrimmage. That told Colin Klein, let's get out of this run. Okay, I'll get one-on-one to the outside. Good pass protection. And I've got the route to the top part. And look at that. Pat Miller giving up a lot of room to Chris Harper for an easy completion.
A gain of 18 yards, first down and 10 of the 27. Thompson in motion. Here's Klein, finds Tremaine Thompson. Down the sideline, spinning, and a flag on the play.
You wonder if the receivers were holding on that play because of the double blocks to the outside, trying to spring the receiver on the wide receiver screen.
Randy Crystal, your referee.
Holding. Offense, number 16. 10-yard penalty, first down.
When you're running this type of a play, look to the outside here. It's Tyler Lockett, number 16. Engage against number 7, Nana Kyrum. And he ends up with the takedown and gets too much cloth. You see the hand on the outside of the pads. The officials caught that one perfectly.
So that'll make it first down and 15 at the 22. And Klein running it again. Trying to set up his blocks. Another flag on the play. Maybe offside. Against West Virginia.
Offside defense, number 95. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's Christian Brown.
Now, didn't Kansas State have a penalty on the first play?
Yes.
And West Virginia just turns right around and hands it right back to them. Those are the things that make coaches nutty. The discipline on a defense that's struggling to begin with, you don't want to hand away yardage or plays to any offense.
First down and 10 at the 27. Klein to throw. Klein hit as he tosses. Oh, what a catch. Tyler Lockett camping under it, but Colin Klein stood in the pocket and took the shot. And that's a gain of 35 yards.
What you're going to get is the route. It's going to be a flag route going to the corner. Chris Harper stops and makes it a one-person route for Tyler Lockett, who beats Garvin, the linebacker, first. And as you noted, partner, look at him stand there, and Jared Barber hits him right in the chops, and he drops him right in the bucket for a huge first down.
Klein, not known as a passing quarterback, gets off to a great beginning, 4-4, 89 yards. First down at the 38. Here's a handoff, and Hubert, the Waco wonder, picks up 4.
He is something, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
I mean, when you take a look at John Hubert at 5'7", 191 listed, broke all the records of LaDainian Tomlinson in the Waco area in high school. Baylor didn't take him. Said their academics was an issue. They worried about his size. Size has not been an issue at all at Kansas State.
Second down at 6 at the 34-yard line. And you can't see him behind Colin Klein. And that's by design.
And that's not even fair for a defense. You get a big offensive line. Colin Klein is 6'5", 6'6". John Hubert hides, and then he squirts free.
Here's Klein. Quick strike this time. Caught by Chris Harper. Harper close to the first down as Pat Miller jumps on him. 5-yard gain.
You feel the deliberateness of the Kansas State offense already. And see, this is what West Virginia has to battle, because they're used to go, 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 especially on the offensive side. And so when Dana Holgorsen gets the ball back, he doesn't want to be impatient. Look at the clock just ticking down as we go along. Already much of the first quarter gone. Kansas State only on their second drive.
Third down and 1 at the 29. Wilson and Hubert in the offset. Here's Hubert, second man through, and he squirts forward and picks up a first down. A gain of 4. Time now to head to Los Angeles in our Aaron Andrews for a game break.
Hey, guests, let's update you on Texas Tech TCU's second overtime. BJ Catalan, 7-yard touchdown pass from Trayvon Boykin. That made it 50-50, but now it's 53-50 TCU in the third overtime, guys.
Oh, that means the field goal was kicked and the door is open for Texas Tech, Aaron. If they score a touchdown, they get to go home a winner.
Texas Tech beating this West Virginia team at home last week. Here's Klein, pump fake, up the sideline. Incomplete, and a flag on the play. Harper, the intended receiver. Ishmael Banks covering.
And Banks has position. He's in good shape. All right, he can hit him there. The ball's not in the air. But he loses sight and really doesn't play the ball very well. He just plays the receiver. That flag's going to go against Banks, because if he had turned and
pass
played the football.
Defense number 34, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
If he turns and plays the ball, he's in good shape. But I think he panicked a little bit, lost sight of it, lost his technique, and turned it into pass interference.
So on their second drive of the game, Kansas State marching it down the field once again. And they'll line up at the West Virginia 10 with a fresh set of downs.
See the play distribution already. Eight rushes. The surprise, they've thrown 5 passes already.
For 94 yards. Hubert. Bottled up. And Hubert fighting his way back to the line of scrimmage.
Doug Gregg on the stops. Okay.
At this stage, the West Virginia defense is thinking field goal attempt. They've given up huge chunks of yardage, but they can hold up to another field goal attempt. Joe DeForest, the defensive coordinator you see on your screen right now, will count that as a victory.
Second down and 10 at the 10. Klein wants to throw it in the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas State. Tyler Lockett over the shoulder. And they say Colin Klein isn't a throwing quarterback, but he's proven a lot of people wrong right now.
and his receivers have confidence in him, and they go get it. Look at this layout by Lockett.
Wow.
Foot down, has the football, takes it all the way to the ground. I think that's going to easily be a touchdown. Well-timed route, throw, and catch. Lockett broke it inside, broke it back outside, and Klein threw it on the break and gave him enough air to go underneath it and get it.
Second receiving touchdown of the year for Tyler Lockett, the sophomore from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Extra point up and good. So how about this? Remember, Kansas State beat Oklahoma on the road, and they start strong here in Morgantown. 9 plays, 92 yards, and they ate up close to 6. Fox College Football is sponsored by Nissan. Innovation that excites. By the Samsung Galaxy S3, the next big thing is already here. And by Bud Light, it's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Kansas State jumping out to a 10-0 lead. In terms of the time of possession battle, the Wildcats have had it for 9 minutes. The Mountaineers for 2.5. As you take a look at the drive, Lockett with the 10-yard over the shoulder, beautiful touchdown reception.
Kansas State just takes time of possession and slaps a sleeper hold on it, don't they?
Yes, they do.
I mean, they were almost 41 minutes time of possession last week at Iowa State in their victory.
Tavon Austin back deep. Anthony Cantelli will send it away. West Virginia has to get something going on offense. And they'll start from the 1-yard line. This is Jordan Thompson. And Thompson is crushed. Terrific tackle on special teams by Weston Hybert. And this is during the break. Coach Holgorsen having a conversation with his squad.
Remember, he said this week that he thought that this was a team that would bow up and come to play. They didn't do that last week against Texas Tech. He thought they sagged in that game. They got down and really looked for the easy way out. He challenged them all week. He's challenging them again tonight.
Lost 49-14 at Tech, and they'll run it. This time, Dustin Garrison with the tackle. And we've been talking a lot about Texas Tech. Let's go back to Los Angeles. Here's Aaron Andrews with the game break.
Let me show you how this one ended in the third overtime. Alex Torres, the 8-yard touchdown pass from Seth Jagy. That was his 7th touchdown pass of the game. He has 13 touchdown passes in his last 2 games, guys.
All right, thank you very much. We will be in Manhattan, Kansas next week for Kansas State, Texas Tech. Geno Smith on the knee and caught a flag on the play. Tavon Austin in heavy traffic.
There's deliberate as the Kansas State offense right now getting this call in.
Fans not happy with the delay.
Holding. Defense number 26. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That's Jarrell Childs, senior from Kansas City, called for holding. So a first down and 10 now to 27. For West Virginia, Coach Schneider, 21st season at Kansas State, 6-0 this year, 3-0 in conference play. Now Geno Smith out of the shotgun. Andrew Bowie the pistol back. And they toss it to Austin on the sweep. And Austin dives forward, gets across the 30-yard line. He picks up about 3.
His quickness and vision enabled him to escape Meshack Williams, number 42, in the backfield, who had gotten upfield and was in a position to make a play on the ball and on the ball carrier right there. But he eluded him and was able to gain a few short yards.
Tavon Austin, first in the nation in catches per game, 11. Last week he had 10 grabs for 92 yards, his seventh consecutive game going back to last season with 10 or more catches. He's a special, special player. Second and seven at the 30. Here's a handoff, Bowie. And Bowie may be a yard. Vailatui, the senior from Salt Lake City with the stop.
We know West Virginia can throw the ball. That's their stock and trade. But right now, Kansas State's defense is doing the dictating, making it a third and long situation.
Third down and six at the 31 for Geno Smith. Empty backfield. His coaches want him to run it a little more to move the chains. Here's Smith. Stepping up. Has it batted out of his hands. Picks it up. And Smith out of bounds. Kansas State bringing pressure. And West Virginia will have to punt once again.
Look from the backside. Meshack Williams, their best pass rusher, goes through and strip sacks it, knocks it out of his hands. And then the running you referred to, Gus, on this one, no chance. Adam Davis, 55. Arthur Brown, number four, had all the lanes closed down. West Virginia has to kick it away again. Kansas State dictating on defense what West Virginia is trying to accomplish.
Bittencourt will punt it from his own 13. Tremaine Thompson back deep. And Thompson comes up to field it at the 35. And goes down at the 34. A 37-yard punt. Bruce with the tackle on special teams. Now next week, folks, Foxtoberfest continues as Fox College Football presented by GEICO heads to Manhattan, Kansas for 17th-ranked Texas Tech. Takes on fourth-ranked Kansas State to showdown between Big 12 rivals. It all starts with the Fox College Saturday pregame show at 3 p.m. Eastern, 12 p.m. Pacific. They got to give a lot of credit to Tommy Tuberville for what his team has been able to accomplish at the start of this season.
And we're looking at the numbers that Seth Dagey, his quarterback, put up today. Seven touchdown passes, but the biggest difference in Texas Tech this year, they're playing much better defense.
First down and 10 at the 36. For Colin Klein, Angelo Pease lines up behind the All-America candidate. Play fake, Klein over the middle. Wide open receiver, Colin Klein putting it right between the 8 and the 6. Tremaine Thompson, another grab.
And how about them throwing the football on first down, knowing that West Virginia wants to load the box inside to try and take away running lanes, and not afraid to use the arm of Colin Klein off to a perfect start, 7 for 7, 118 yards and a touchdown.
This will probably be the last play of the first quarter, which has been dominated by Kansas State from midfield. First down. Klein will throw it again. Klein going deep. Incomplete. Chris Harper was open. And that takes us to the end of the first quarter in Morgantown, West Virginia, with the score, Kansas State 10, West Virginia nothing. Fox College Football will be back after these messages. Fourth-ranked Kansas State on the road, up 10-0 as we take a look at the first quarter stats.
And every one of them is a surprise on West Virginia's side. Only 12 yards passing it, 21 yards total, 5:27 time of possession. No surprise at all for Kansas State at 9:33 in time of possession, dominating the first quarter of action.
Colin Klein throwing for 118 yards in the first quarter. And West Virginia is a team ranked sixth in the nation, averaging 543 yards per game. Second and 10 at midfield. Klein. Play fit. Steps up in the pocket with a lane. Colin Klein, first down and more as a big boy rumbles to the 30. Isaiah Bruce with the stop, but that's a 19-yard gain.
Okay, watch. Look at what they've got here coming at Colin Klein, and he recognizes it. All right, as they start to roll this play, Colin Klein now sees the blitz coming, and once that happens, gets a nice block in the backfield from Angelo Pease, and then gets upfield using his legs to hurt the defense. Geno Smith, that's something he needs to add to his game for West Virginia.
First down and 10 at the 32 for Klein and the Wildcats. He'll run the option this time. Here's the pitch, Pease. And he'll hop out of bounds gaining 7 yards on the play. Angelo, a senior from Cairo, Georgia, in for John Hubert.
And you know what's happening besides the fact they're gaining yardage? Is that they're dealing blows on every play. All right, so the physical part of the game is all on the side of Kansas State now, which means their confidence continues to rise as this game goes on.
Second and three at the 25. And they hand it off to Pease, who'll pick up a first down. Darwin Cook trips him up. But the thing about this Kansas State squad, their intelligence is, they're just remarkably intelligent football players. And according to Coach Snyder, sometimes they run two or three different offenses at the same time.
Yeah, when you look at them, they've got the spread elements, okay? They've got some veer elements to them. They got a little pro style, you name it. They put it all together, and they mishmash it together quite effectively.
First down and 10 at the 20. Klein flings it out to his receiver, Tyler Lockett. And a nice open field tackle by Terrence Garvin.
And that's a good play by Garvin. Those are the types of plays they need for West Virginia, who I'm watching essentially blitzing on every play. Doesn't matter whether it's a run down or a pass down. They're trying to force the action, trying to get into the backfield of Kansas State, trying to create turnovers.
Second down and 9. Here's the option. Pease turns the corner. Pease, first down. Pease dives forward and gets to the 3. Carl Joseph stops him, but it's a 17-yard pickup on 2nd and 9.
And they absolutely destroy your rules about what you do, because he's going to take quarterback, but there's no one for the pitch back. See, there's Garvin 28, but where's the person who's supposed to take the pitch? No one there. That allows Pease to get to the corner and get to the third level, which is the secondary, for another nice game.
First down and goal now at the 3 for Kansas State. Total domination thus far. Colin Klein. And he'll go down at the 1-yard line. Darwin Cook with the tackle.
Gus, you noticed something early in the game about Colin Klein and how he waits for his blockers, how he has that patience in running. Did you see that little hop step there to make sure the blocker had time to clear and lead him up into the hole? He's one of the most patient runners we've seen in the college game, because he knows if he waits, then he'll read the blocking assignments and the defensive assignments and find the right place to run the football.
He leads the Big 12 with 10 rushing touchdowns. 9th play of the drive. 2nd and goal. Klein, quarterback sneak.
When he falls forward, it's usually a touchdown.
Touchdown. He used all 6'5", 226 pounds to get in. His 11th rushing touchdown of the season.
Watch the pile. Okay, everybody's got it all stacked up, but eventually gravity's going to take over, right? You see him pushing, pushing, and as gravity takes over, he falls forward, just what you mentioned. All 6'5 now gets across the goal line. Another touchdown for Kansas State.
Dana Holgerson's Mountaineers getting smacked around on their home field with 11:23 to go in the 2nd quarter. Extra point up and good. 17-0, K-State. Kansas State with the lead. And it's time now for our Aflac trivia question. Kansas State is one of 2 schools to start the last 2 seasons 6-0. Who is the other team? Coach Bill Snyder, his Kansas State football team, looking for a slice of history today. It's 4th straight Big 12 road victory over a ranked opponent. The Wildcats have already won 3 in succession at Texas last season and at both Oklahoma and Iowa State in 2012.
You know what I think they do as well as, if not better than anyone in the country? Is that they just play the game. They're not worried about the name that they're playing. They're not worried about the ranking that they're playing. They take care of themselves first. Very similar to John Wooden at UCLA. No scout, you know, he didn't scout people. All he said was, we take care of ourselves and go from there.
And Austin brings it out of the end zone. Austin crosses the 10 and gets up to the 13-yard line. Now let's go to Aaron Andrews for a game break.
Gus, USC, Colorado. Matt Barkley here with 17-yard touchdown pass to Robert Woods. That's his fifth pass of the game, touchdown pass of the game. He now has 101 touchdown passes. He takes the career. That's with the Pac-12 record. Robert Woods, by the way, becomes the all-time USC reception leader with that catch as well. So a lot of records being broken tonight at USC.
All right. We will see USC in Oregon on November 3rd here on Fox. Geno Smith over the middle, incomplete. Intended for J.D. Woods.
And now you're hearing the crowd get restless. So you're worried about now the kids starting to really press. Julie Alexandria talked about Dana Holgorsen telling Geno Smith it's go time. It's time for you to will your team to a victory, to bring them along. Will he continue to play with the calm we've seen for most of the year? Or will he get too amped up now and try and do too much?
Smith, 2 of 4, 12 yards. Third drive of the game for West Virginia. Underneath, that's Austin. He'll pick up a first down. Ty Zimmerman, the safety, with the tackle.
Picked up a first down, trying to increase the tempo now as they try and move forward. The one name we have not heard so far in the passing attack, Stedman Bailey, who hurt a foot last week at Texas Tech. How healthy is he? There's Bailey at the top of the screen.
He did practice this week. First down and 10, play action. Smith in trouble. Smith wants to tuck it. He gets outside. And Geno Smith will gain 3 yards.
He wants to keep a play alive as long as possible so he can throw the football and deliver it downfield. And I like that attribute in him. But I think with his team struggling a little bit now, it probably wouldn't hurt if he takes a look, maybe a second look, and sometimes squirts free into the secondary and hurts the defense with his legs, picking up yardage.
Garrison catches a swing pass, and Garrison crosses the 30 up to the 32. Meshack Williams with the tackle. And one thing the West Virginia coaches told us when we were at their facility yesterday, they're so impressed with Coach Snyder's team's ability to really bring guys to the turf.
They tackle so well. You catch the ball, they tackle you almost on the spot. And West Virginia's used to a lot of yardage after the catch.
Third down and 4. Geno Smith underneath. First down, West Virginia. Now the Mountaineers managing to move the ball. That's Stedman Bailey. I think he heard you from way up here.
He had a little hitch in his giddy-up when I watched him practice on Thursday, but now they're bringing the crowd back into it. And what did they get on that play, what we just discussed? The yak yardage. The yardage after the catch is built into what Dana Holgorsen runs on offense.
Bailey, first in the nation in scoring, averaging 14 points a game. He missed the second half with that ankle injury after catching 6 balls for 56 yards against Tech and a touchdown. Smith, incomplete. Meshack Williams make that Malone covering. Bailey, the intended receiver. And the West Virginia fans wanted a flag.
And that's part of what you just talked about, their ability to tackle on the spot. Nigel Malone was all over the receiver. The fans thought he was there too early. But Ryan Mueller, number 44, forced the throw quickly. And Malone was right on the play to help break it up.
Second down and 10 of the 44. Smith gets it off, and there they are to stop him once again. This is Copeland with the reception. Smith under pressure.
And Kansas State's not a big blitz team, but watch Arthur Brown on this play as he goes to Geno Smith. He and Adam Davis, 55 on the backside, combined to get their hit in on Geno.
So that makes it third down and 10 at the 44. West Virginia, 1 of 3 on third down conversions. Empty backfield for Smith. Geno to the sideline. Garrison will not pick up the first down as he gets to the 50. Nigel Malone ushering him out of bounds. And look at this. This is good. This is what they do. Look at the coverage downfield. They take away the downfield options, make him throw it short. And then when they throw it short, look at that. There's nowhere to go. They rally up, make the tackle. The crowd's upset because they want him to go for it on fourth down. Dana Holgorsen wants to help his defense, maybe with a little field position. Tyler Lockett standing at the 12-yard line for Kansas State. Bittencourt will punt it from the 35. And he shanked it. Gets a kind bounce and it's down at the 24. So Kansas State with the football once again, 7:55 to go in the second quarter. Here comes Colin Klum. Fox College Football is sponsored by the new 2013 Ford F-150 with EcoBoost. 17-0. Kansas State leading West Virginia. Now tomorrow night, folks, Foxtoberfest continues as we bring you game 6 of the NLCS, with the Cardinals once again looking to clinch the pennant while the Giants try to force a decisive game 7. Legends are born in October, and our coverage of game 6 of the NLCS begins tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. How about Barry Zito?
Remember when they thought Barry Zito would never be a frontline guy again? That looked like the Barry Zito of old.
As the American League champion Detroit Tigers wait, the winner of that.
Somehow I knew that.
Did I say that they were the American League champions?
Yeah, I do believe that came up once or twice.
First down and 10 at the 25. Klein. And this is Harper turning it up, and Harper gets to the 45. Doug Rigg with the tackle, but Colin Klein has been pitching it this evening.
And his receivers are giving him excellent targets to throw to. Look at the first three possessions for Kansas State. Field goal, touchdown, touchdown. The second drive, 92 yards for touchdown.
First down and 10 at the 44. Some feel that this game will allow either Klein or Geno Smith to really distinguish themselves as the Heisman frontrunner. And in the first half, it's all Colin Klein. And he's been doing it with his arm. Here's a jump pass, Sammy Ballstein. Travis Tannehill with the reception.
As if we needed one more reason to compare Colin Klein to Tim Tebow. Right? I mean, he's showing it all tonight. You just talked about the National League Championship Series and the pitchers showing a wide variety. They always have a wide variety of pitches. We're seeing that from Colin Klein tonight. We've seen the long ball, the intermediate ball, ball down the middle to the sidelines on the post corner. Now he goes jump pass in the middle of the field. Coupled with it, added to his running ability, he's showing everything this evening.
He's been almost perfect. 10 of 11, 149 yards and a touchdown. And no run at this time. And Hubert spinning. Such a low center of gravity for John Hubert as Carl Joseph comes up with the tackle.
You know what I'd like to see? A reel of the times that John Hubert was tackled one-on-one and didn't spin away from someone. Because it'd be a very short reel. Almost every time there's contact, he finds a way to slide, move, spin, and continue to get forward for additional yardage.
Second down and 3 at the 38. Out of the offset eye, Hubert, the deep man, and they give it to him. Hubert, first down, Kansas State. As we talked about in the break, as you mentioned, this is a pivotal drive for West Virginia.
And they're doing everything possible to try and stack the line of scrimmage, add more people to the box to limit the run game. Joe DeForest had told us he was going to try and, you know, mug the line of scrimmage, maybe even run blitz a lot to try and fill up holes. But oftentimes when you run blitz, if you don't fit it perfectly, creases appear. And we just saw one there for another decided game by Kansas State.
First down at the 31. Play fake. Klein sets up deep. Lets it fly. On the button. Lock it. I thought this kid couldn't throw it.
Everyone keeps saying that, and you and I have talked about this over the 2 years we've been together. And I think we've come to a consensus. We don't care how it looks. Does it get there? Is it on time? Is it in the right place? Colin Klein will never be a training tape for how to throw the football. But who cares? I don't care if he's on his head. I don't care if he's throwing it behind his back, drop kicking it off the stadium top. That ball's getting to his receivers with dispatch.
A 19-yard gain, first down and 10 at the 22. Hubert. Darwin Cook comes up and makes the stop. But Hubert gains 4 yards.
And Dana Holgorsen talked about this week. Who's going to bow up and take a plant their feet and make a stand for his West Virginia defense? So far, we have not seen that in the first half. Kansas State having their way, allowing Colin Klein to throw early in the downs and throwing for big yardage when he does so.
Second and 6 at the 8. Klein runs the option, keeps it, turns, touchdown K-State. Wow.
As he comes down the line, it's the patience again. This time, he's going to have the option of pitching it or tucking it. See, right here, you got him taking the pitch, and he tucks it inside because he sees the momentum going the proper way. They're all the way outside. He sticks a foot in the ground, turns his shoulders upfield, and barrels his way into the end zone for another Kansas State touchdown. Truly having their way with West Virginia's defense this evening.
And the Wildcats, with 4:27 remaining in the second quarter, go up 24-0. Colin Klein now running it. It's pay dirt, his second rushing touchdown of the night.
Coming up on the Pizza Hut halftime, records are being broken in the Coliseum. Texas Tech and TCU was a triple overtime throwdown in Fort Worth. And the number one team in the land, Alabama, is in action. That's all next with Joey and Eddie on the Pizza Hut halftime.
With 4 minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the second quarter, a surprising score, folks. Kansas State led by that man, Colin Klein, with a 24-0 lead.
I think what a lot of people around the country have grasped onto over the years with Kansas State is that they are that scrappy, overachieving type of a team, especially in this latest incarnation with Bill Snyder. I think we need to go ahead and bury that myth. All right, that's not who they are. This is one of the best football teams in the country, and West Virginia has a heck of a battle now to try and get back into it.
For the Mountaineers, trying to find some kind of momentum as Tavon Austin takes it out of the end zone. Austin with a seam. Austin breaks away. There it is. Tavon Austin. 100 big ones.
Was terrific as he moved to his left, opened up the hole. He saw the vision back right, and then he ends up in the end zone, and the spark you're looking for was just lit by Tavon Austin.
4:13 to go in the second quarter. West Virginia finally on the board. The young man from Baltimore, Maryland, with the big play, 24-7. Fox College Football is sponsored by Miller Lite. It's not just a good time, it's Miller time. By Aflac, official partner of the Heisman Trophy. And by T-Mobile, test drive our nationwide 4G network. Welcome back to Morgantown. The fans here finally with something to smile about as Tavon Austin returns a kickoff. 100 yards, his fourth career kickoff return for a touchdown. But remember, Kansas State does it pretty well with Tyler Lockett. He's averaging 31 yards per return on kickoffs, eighth in the nation, and he has a touchdown.
And that return by Austin was what kept Bill Snyder up a little bit later this week. He told me earlier this week that his biggest challenge in special teams was trying to cover their kickoff unit because of the skill of Austin.
Lockett from the six. And Lockett shot down at the 22-yard line. Garrett Hope with the tackle on special teams. They're starting to call this kid Optimus Klein as we take a look at his numbers.
He already had the record for quarterbacks in terms of rushing touchdowns. Now he's tied the school record set by Darren Sproles. He's behind our own Eric Crouch, our colleague here at Fox Sports, in Big 12 history, and 39 in the last two seasons, a record for quarterbacks in football bowl subdivision. This drive is all about the West Virginia defense as we start it, though. Can they help out now after the offense helped them with the kick return?
First down and 10 at the 32. Pease. All sorts of running room as Pease gains 8 yards on the play.
He started the season as the lead guy at running back before Hubert took over midway through the first game of the year. And it's been a while since Pease has had a good number of carries. But Hubert got cut earlier in the game and is spending a little bit extra time on the bench. And Pease has stepped into the breach quite well.
Second and three. Klein to throw it. Sideline. Caught first down by Chris Harper. Now let's answer our Aflac trivia question. Kansas State is one of two schools to start the last two seasons 6-0. Who is the other team? Well, the number one team in the nation.
About that, the Alabama Crimson Tide.
We've got Tennessee tonight. Your boys.
Third Saturday in October, Gus, one of the great rivalries in college football. Oh, I'm sorry.
First down and 10 at the 37. You were about to get on a roll.
Oh, sorry about that.
Here's Klein. Play fake. Klein winding up, wide open. Incomplete. Wow, he had Tyler Lockett, but he put too much on it.
Oh, this is a layup, too. Look at the cushion that these wide receivers are getting, and still they run by Ricky Rump, number 41. A little bit more air, and Tyler Lockett still running into the end zone. Did you see the cushion Ricky Rump gave him? That was at least a 12-yard cushion. And even with that, Tyler Lockett runs by him. The cornerbacks for West Virginia are playing with a decided lack of confidence in the corner. No one going up and really challenging the receivers for Kansas State.
Second and 10. Klein, he does it again. This time on the button. Tyler Lockett with the catch, and it's a gain of 44.
Well, you miss one. And again, that's at least a 12-yard cushion, a double move that Carl Joseph, number 8, bites on, and Tyler Lockett runs past him. I'm not sure what the West Virginia defensive backs are looking at in terms of their eyes and their keys, because one move takes them out of their coverage very easily.
Lockett, 6 catches, 140 yards, and the touchdown in the first half. And a timeout called by K-State as the play clock wound down, 24-7. Last week, West Virginia trailed 35-7 at halftime. It could be 31-7 today. If the West Virginia's defense doesn't step up as Geno Smith gets loose. First down and 10 at the 19.
Heard about wide open playbooks. Kansas State, they can do whatever they want right now.
Klein to Lockett. And Lockett picks up 6.
You know, Bill Snyder's been referred to many times as the scheme master. You alluded to it earlier, Gus, with the different types of offenses that they incorporate in their overall attack. And he's hitting West Virginia inside, outside, deep, short, with power running the football. The Mountaineers have to find a way to create a turnover and help themselves out.
Klein will run it on second and four. West Virginia closing in after the 2-yard gain. Isaiah Bruce on the bottom of the pile for the Mountaineers brings up third down and two.
And you see the clock ticking down. Kansas State's well aware of that. Their idea of finishing the half is to let it bleed out as they fall into the end zone. Under no hurry right now.
That's a movement on the right side
of
the K-State.
Offense number 73. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Stavon Rooks.
So unusual for them. You know, they had 9 penalties last week at Iowa State. Prior to that game, they had 9 penalties for the season.
Fifth time Kansas State has been in the red zone in the first half. 3 touchdowns. Third down and 7.
Look for the pressure to come from West Virginia's defense here.
He's the pistol back. Here's the option. Klein takes it. First down and more. Colin Klein down at the 1.
They brought the pressure, but they came into the get. Watch. They go inside here. That leaves all that out there. There's no one as they run off the secondary guy. Look at this. There's no one there. Klein's just running to the corner. No need for a trail back. The big fella going. Darwin Cook is the only reason he doesn't get into the end zone with a saving tackle.
First down and goal at the 1. 29 seconds remaining in the first half. Here's Klein. He's got 2 rushing touchdowns. Make it 3. Once again, Colin Klein finding the end zone, and Kansas State takes a 30-7 lead with 17 seconds to go. Cantelli comes in to attempt the extra point. 31-7, K-State. Colin Klein using his legs. The Wildcats complete domination. And coming up at the half, it's the Pizza Hut halftime show with Aaron and the guys. They'll cover a lot of action today, including a record-breaking day for SC. Texas Tech in a thriller. Alabama visiting Knoxville.
Upset-minded Tennessee, by the way.
Charles Davis, a proud Tennessee All-SEC graduate.
Just for the record, 4-1 against Alabama. I'll leave it at that.
So West Virginia will receive Tavon Austin. This time he takes a knee. Introducing the UPS Team Performance Index, a new statistical measure that looks at the efficiency of a team's offense, defense, special teams, and miscues to define their competitive advantage. Check out the UPS Team Performance Index throughout the season for a look at the logistics behind a winning team.
I'm not quite sure how we define efficiency there, but can there really truly be a more efficient team than the one we're watching tonight in Kansas State in the country?
Well, when you look at the numbers, Kansas State racking up 345 yards of total offense in the first half, and their defense holding West Virginia to 57. Geno Smith. This reception made by Ivan McCartney.
And you see West Virginia with a score 31-7 in no mood at all.
West Virginia, for a second time out of the half, it's a 37.
And West Virginia calling a timeout.
Yeah, they're in no mood to just take a knee and go to the locker room at the half. Yeah, Dana Holgorsen saying maybe we can break something. Maybe we can get something big with their skilled receivers. You know, they can shake a few tackles and go the distance and feel better going in at the half. There's really no risk at this point. If something happens in the backfield, Kansas State scores. You take that chance, that's easy.
Over the last six quarters, West Virginia has been outscored 80 to 21.
Texas Tech was last week. We'll see them next week against this Kansas State team in Manhattan. And now West Virginia trying to get something before the half, get a little momentum.
Second down and one. Smith. And incomplete.
And the pressure from Kansas State is really just from the front three or four. They're not a huge blitz team. But Adam Davis, 55, Meshack Williams, 42. And Geno Smith just broke the record in one single season, 272 throws without an interception, breaking Trent Dilfer's record. But that's not one he's real happy about at the moment.
Fired it out wide, McCartney. And that is the end of the first half. A shocking score at halftime. Kansas State on the road on top of West Virginia, 31-7. Now let's go to Aaron Andrews in LA.
All right, guys, thanks so much. Coming up on the Pizza Hut halftime, USC is having a record-breaking game at the Coliseum. The Red Raiders and Horned Frogs battle into triple overtime in their Big 12 matchup, and number one Alabama is in action at Tennessee. That's all up next with these guys, Eddie and Joey, on the Pizza Hut halftime.
We're ready to start the third quarter here in Morgantown, Kansas State, with the big 31-7 lead over West Virginia. Gus Johnson, along with Charles Davis, used an interesting word during the break. Kansas State playing with incredible discipline
in everything except for one kickoff coverage where Tavon Austin brought it back for a touchdown. But overall, on offense, the discipline and how they move the football, methodical, deliberate, and it ends up in the end zone. Led by Colin Klein. In defense, they filled every gap. But Colin Klein was the story coming into the game, and as the game unfolded, continued to be the story. His arm surprising many people early in the game. But how about the legs and the vision as he sees the openings and the holes in the defense and uses his legs to get there. And then when he needs some power, he has it. Turns it upfield, gets to the end zone. How about the three rushing touchdowns in the first half? But his arm really stung West Virginia too.
That brings us to the Dodge game summary.
Look at that. This is eighth career game with three or more rushing touchdowns, three in the first half for Colin Klein. Geno Smith didn't have the ball very much, less than 10 minutes on offense, just 62 yards throwing the football. And look at the total yards. West Virginia, 74 total yards coming into the game. This is a team that is used to putting up huge numbers, while Kansas State put 345 on the board.
So ready to start the second half. West Virginia will get the football. Tavon Austin in that first half, returning a kickoff 100 yards for a touchdown. The only score of the game thus far for the Mountaineers. What do you tell your team if you're Dana Holgorsen at halftime?
Well, yeah, you're going to talk about effort. You're going to talk about continuing to play hard. You're going to talk about trying to get something going in the first 5 minutes of the half. Remember, Austin brought back a kickoff already. Why not another one trying to find the spark?
And they'll bring it out of the end zone. Here's Austin. Austin sprinting. Flag on the play. Tavon Austin almost popped another one. But let's see.
Holding, return team number 88. Half the distance, first and 10.
So this one will come back. Meanwhile, let's go down to the sideline to Julie Alexandria.
Hey, Gus, I got a chance to catch up with Coach Snyder going into the half to ask his thoughts on how his team has done in the first half. And he said, well, we're doing just fine. And anytime you can stop West Virginia from making plays, well, we're doing all right. And when I asked him about Colin Klein, he said, he's doing just fine. What can you say? He's a man of few words, Gus.
And Julie, I'm guessing that when you caught up to Coach, you were on the move, weren't you?
That is absolutely correct. He does not stop for anybody, let me tell you.
That's why you keep working out, trying to stay in shape, keep up with Coach Snyder, run into the locker room.
That's the right. He's the only guy that runs away from me.
First down and 10. Duly noted, Julie. At the 9, Geno Smith. All deflected on the ground, intercepted. It's gone from bad to worse for West Virginia. First interception of the year for Geno Smith.
Take a look at the coverage here, okay? You guys see Randall Evans, 15, reading the coverage, and he falls back into the play, tips it up, which he has done numerous times this year. That's the third tip ball by Randall Evans this season that's resulted in an interception by a teammate. Plays the nickelback for them, tackles well, and how about the coverage? Arthur Brown with another pick for Kansas State.
The Wildcats with the football at the West Virginia 24. First down for Klein. John Hubert. And Hubert breaks a tackle, moves forward.
That was as solid a tackle, Gus, as you're going to see, and he runs through it.
Geno Smith on the phone, first interception of the season. Frustrating day for Smith. Different story for Colin Klein. He's on his way to a 300-yard passing game. Second and 6, 3 rushing touchdowns in the first half. Line, pump fake, over the middle, caught, touchdown, Wildcats, Chris Harper, and Colin Klein put that football in a shoebox,
and he had to. Did you see the coverage? As he released the ball, I thought to myself, this is the first mistake he's made in the throwing game tonight. Watch where he puts it, and look where the blue jerseys are. Look at that. And even got away with interference. And Harper comes up with the ball because Joseph grabs him before it gets there. But Joseph had no idea where the ball was. And that allowed Klein to fit it in. What'd you say? In the shoebox? Right in there. Perfect throw.
Colin Klein, what a performance. And I'm sure the Heisman voters are watching. And right now, they may be watching the front runner. First, Geno Smith throws his first interception of the season to start the second half. And then Optimus Klein in double coverage with a touchdown. 3 touchdowns rushing, 2 passing. 38-7 Kansas State.
Everybody remembers the play.
Fox College Football is sponsored by Pizza Hut. Make it great. By Firestone, reminding you that whatever you drive, drive a Firestone. And by UPS, let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you. Welcome back to Morgantown, West Virginia. And Kansas State up 38-7. A dejected group of Mountaineer fans looking on. And they've seen Colin Klein. His career high passing is 281 yards. We start the third quarter. He's 15 of 17, 247, 2 touchdowns, no picks, and he's rushed for 3 touchdowns. Tavon Austin starts from the 1. And Tavon Austin going down. Jake Cantelli. Make that Curry Sexton with the tackle on special teams as we take a look at the Heisman watch.
And this is how we started the night with Geno Smith, Manti Te'al, Jordan Poyer, the cornerback from Oregon State. But this guy right here, goes all the way to the top now, head of the class. A wise man once said, power isn't something given to you. Power is something you take. Colin Klein has seized this moment and moved himself into the number one slot in terms of Heisman contenders.
Austin. They get a yard. Are you surprised with the way he's been able to throw the football?
I've been surprised at the evolution of him as a thrower. As he's continued to get better. You know, he's gained more confidence. He worked hard on it in the offseason. I saw him at the Manning Academy working on his mechanics. And I still say he's never going to be aesthetically pleasing. But remember what we said? Who cares? It doesn't matter. It's whether it gets there, and boy, is it getting there.
And Geno Smith sacked for the second time. Meshack Williams getting to the quarterback.
Looked like he had some help too, didn't it? I saw a few white shirts there. They all just converged on Geno Smith, just descended. And West Virginia having to move quickly, trying to find a spark, trying to get something going.
Third down at 16. Smith steps up and sacked again. Guess who? Meshack Williams. So West Virginia unraveling to start the third quarter.
And this isn't even fair because he's not blocked on this play. Look at this. You saw Jeff Braun, number 57, step over. Meshack Williams, just a quick arm over move. And that contact he had with Jeff Braun was fleeting until he got to the quarterback.
Four sacks this season for Meshack. And West Virginia will have to punt it away. Bittencourt in the back of his own end zone.
And he hasn't hit it very well in the few punts he's had this season.
False start. Got a false start on number 7. Half the distance, fourth down.
How far could you really move it? It wasn't a lot of room for even half the distance, was there?
Right now, Bittencourt wedged in the back of his own end zone. Gets it away. Thompson from the 45. Thompson at the 30. Thompson down the sideline. Juking and goes down at the 16. Jermaine Thompson with a 30-yard return. Isaiah Bruce with the tackle. And Kansas State in business once again.
No room to punt it. And then he hits a low liner, which is a really good return ball. And then look at the blocking. Gives him the gap. Good block there by number 14. Look like Jack Cantelli. Excuse me, I take that back. It's Curry Sexton. They share a number. That's Curry Sexton, who's a backup wide receiver. Helped open the gates for him.
First down and 10 at the 16 for Kansas State. Here's the handoff. Hubert breaks the tackle. Hubert spinning, holds on to the ball, and picks up 9 yards. Ismail Banks with the tackle.
If you're an offensive lineman for Kansas State, are you doing nothing right now but having fun? When you look at the scoreboard, and you see the clock, you see the score, you know that now your head coach is going to lean on you guys to go ahead and run the football, run the clock. That's when it's fun to be an offensive lineman, firing out and smacking people.
Second down and 1. Hubert. This time, he'll be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Shaq Rowell.
Well, the play that's been most effective here, if they don't want to run it inside, has been option. Colin Klein getting to the corner to the trail back.
Third down and 1. spin it. First down and more. John Hubert picks up 4 yards. And a first down and goal now for the Wildcats.
I mean, I just think whirling dervish here. Look at this. You think you've got him lined up, and he spins on Carl Joseph, who's maybe the best tackler on the West Virginia defense. And he came up empty, and Hubert picks up another first down.
19 first downs for Kansas State. First and goal at the West Virginia 3. Clyde looking for a scoring rushing touchdown. And he goes down to the 1. Josh Francis keeps him out of the end zone.
It's just a joy for this Kansas State team to produce for their quarterback. Normally when you have a guy with the kind of stats Colin Klein has, there's some jealousy involved. Guys want their own. Not this Kansas State team. They're just there to support Colin Klein.
Quarterback sneak. Touchdown. Wow. 4 rushing touchdowns for Colin Klein, 2 passing touchdowns. And Kansas State walloping West Virginia 44-7. Minutes remaining in the third quarter. Kansas State with a 45-7 lead. They've got a true leader, Colin Klein. Fox College Football is sponsored by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram. 45-7. Kansas State with 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Gus Johnson, Charles Davis, Julie Alexandria, Colin Klein. 6 total touchdowns tonight. Ties a career high. 4 rushing, 2 passing.
Looks like he's getting a little medical attention over there. I mean, you know, the elbows are so scabbed over at this point from all being ripped up before. For him, it's just another day at the office. Another day, another bruise.
Frustration setting in for Geno Smith and company. West Virginia receiving. Davon Austin, Thompson back deep. Here's Austin. Davon Austin trying to break it out. Crosses the 25, gets up to the 27. Let's go downstairs to Julie Alexandria.
Hey guys, Geno Smith not happy at all right now. He pulled his team together on the sidelines and said, "We got to man up, guys, and it starts with me. We got to make up for what is happening. We got to do whatever we need to do, and each guy has to do his job." And after that last touchdown, he threw a chair. Very frustrated down here.
Thank you, Julie. First down and 10 at the 26 for Smith as he hands it off. And this is Garrison. Close to the first down, and they give it to him.
He's trying to be the leader that they need. The hard part is, with the score being what it is, it's not just one side of the ball. Neither side producing for West Virginia. Look at the possessions tonight. Many punts on there, something they're not used to doing.
And the tackle made by Evans. As Copeland made the reception.
Everybody keeps saying that Kansas State may not have the same athletes that all their programs have. They don't have this, they don't have that. Gus, we've seen them twice now. I don't buy that. I'm buying watching a team that has terrific athletes who play super disciplined.
Smith flipping it to the sideline, caught by Garrison out of the backfield in front of Randall Evans.
Good catch by Garrison. coming out of the backfield, hauling it down and putting them in a position for third and short.
Geno Smith trying to spark his team, third down and two at the 44. Dustin Garrison, first down. Garrison still running. And he will get to the Kansas State 46. Travis Britz stops him. West Virginia now moving the chains here in the third quarter. Down big.
Not something you see much of from West Virginia. When I talked with Trent Dilfer, he said one of the reasons you have those long streaks without interceptions, it's not just the quarterback's accuracy, it's wide receivers catching the football, not bobbling it, popping it up for people to intercept. That's what he has here at West Virginia too.
Second and 10. Smith to the sideline. Caught, McCartney gets out of bounds. Junior from Miami brings up third down and one at the 37.
He's another piece of that Miramar High School connection. Geno Smith, Stedman Bailey, Ivan McCartney.
Best drive of the night so far for West Virginia. Flag on the play. Bowie picks up the first down.
Offside, defense number 55. 5 yard penalty. The game sufficient for a first down.
Davis called for offside. Another first down for the Mountaineers at the 32. Bowie the pistol back. They give it to him. Tell you, this Kansas State team will hit you. That's Jared Milo.
But that was just textbook filling the hole, taking away the cutback, form tackling, and going through the running back. Now that was a training tape.
Smith pumping. Intercepted. Wow. Zimmerman. And Zimmerman goes down to the 24. Second interception of the night. Second interception of the season for Geno Smith. Kansas State with all the answers tonight in Morgantown. 6 minutes to play in the third, 45-7 Kansas State. This week, the Fox College Football Social Poll on Facebook asked fans which top 10 team in the initial BCS standings is the most overrated, and 59% of the over 40,000 fans that voted said Notre Dame. I don't agree with this. They played the toughest schedule probably of any of these teams.
Yeah, I think part of it is they've had a few close calls along the way. And then, you know, Notre Dame is one of those schools that you either love Notre Dame or you don't love Notre Dame. They're a very polarizing group, and they attract a lot of attention.
I'll tell you one thing that isn't overrated. One team, rather, and it's this Kansas State squad. Colin Klein throwing again. Wow! Lock it. I think Bill Snyder is trying to get the Heisman Trophy for Colin Klein right now.
They just continue to roll. Absolutely. And part of what's going on is you have a secondary that has no confidence. All right? So they're having a hard time guarding people because they're afraid to press them and get up on them. The other part is Colin Klein had plenty of time on that play. Offensive line able to give him as much time as he needed for the double move to throw the ball to the wide side of the field.
Up 45-7. Snyder still throwing. Klein 16 of 18, 275 yards. Pease. And let's go to Aaron Andrews in Los Angeles for a game break.
You guys talking about Kansas State rolling. How about Baylor? Lanier Sampson, 7-yard touchdown pass from Nick Florence. Baylor leads 28-21. The Bears trying to beat Texas for the third straight year. That would be the first time in school history if they did that.
All right, thank you very much, Aaron. Texas blown out last week by Oklahoma.
Those have the best defense in the Big 12 in preseason. That has not come close to holding up.
Longhorns having problems tackling. Second and 10 at the 49. Klein to the sideline. Caught again by Harper. Harper flying up the sideline. And Chris Harper. Another first down for K-State. K.J. Dillon with the saving tackle. And it's a gain of 25 yards.
And you brought up the point, 45-7 lead, still throwing the football. A lot of that's dictated by how West Virginia is attacking them defensively. If they're going to continue, and you see the first 300-yard game in Colin Klein's career throwing the football, they're going to continue to mug the line and bring a lot of pressure. Then Bill Snyder's going to owe it to his team to throw the football and not run his running backs into the teeth of that pressure.
Here's a handoff. Keys gets outside. And Keys will pick up 8 yards on the play. Flag, though.
That came in around the point of contact at the tackle. That was thrown back from that side.
It looks a block in the back. Number 86. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That's Tremaine Thompson. Call for the illegal block.
See him working there against number 7, Nana Kyrum. And he wanted to pull off, but as Kyrum slowed up, Tremaine Thompson ran right over the top of it.
First down and 12. Shovel pass, Pease. And he's gang tackled after a 3-yard pickup at the 22. What is it about Bill Snyder? I mean, he's a special, special man. A man of few words.
Few words to us. You know, he's going to tell us, he's going to be affable with us, not going to reveal a whole lot, going to make us decipher it on our own. And that's fine, that's what you do. But look at this, most wins since 1990 among active coaches. And remember, Bill Snyder had a 3-year hiatus before coming back. Imagine what that number would be if he had stayed with it.
Second down and 9. It's going to be interesting for us. I've never been there to go to Manhattan next week.
You'll enjoy it.
Where the stadium's named after this man. There's a highway named after this man. And folks, usually when we get a chance to talk to coaches, the visiting coaches, we talk to them on a conference call on Wednesday. And most head coaches will spend maybe 20 to 30 minutes with us. For Coach Snyder, 7 minutes. Consistent.
Get in, get out. Ask what you need. He'll give you what you ask for, and then he's ready to go.
And he says the same thing every time we talk to him. Oh, well, we're going to try to get better.
And we see each and every week they do exactly that.
Here's Klein to throw over the middle. Caught again. Touchdown. Tyler Lockett.
Stop, okay?
With the touchdown from Colin Klein. A career day for Colin Klein as Kansas State goes up 51-7.
He's thrown a lot of pretty passes tonight. I don't think there's any prettier than this one. Look at that. Look at where he fit it. Over the top of Isaiah Bruce, the linebacker, 31, into the waiting mitts of Tyler Lockett.
Third passing touchdown of the night for Klein. He's rushed for 4 touchdowns. 2:25 to go, and we're still only in the third quarter. Kansas State continuing to rack up points. Let's take a look at the impact players throughout the history of these two football programs. Oliver Luck, athletic director here now. Who can forget Major Harris?
Major Harris grabbed the imagination of this Mountaineer family. like no other player, I think, throughout time. Pat White came along and put up the big numbers after that. Geno Smith now in that position, trying to be that guy, but Colin Klein obviously would be added to that list when we call the roll in future years. And I think that he'll stand as that icon at Kansas State, as Tim Tebow stands at the University of Florida. That one touchstone that everyone could in the future, we're gonna talk about, that guy was here.
West Virginia from the 10. Tavon Austin up the sideline. And Austin out of bounds at the 37. Now let's go to Los Angeles for a game break. Here's Aaron.
Let's get you updated on Florida State, Miami. The Noles are down 10-0. James Wilder with the 17-yard touchdown run, and Florida State ties it up at 10. We're in the second quarter, guys.
Aaron looking like his dad. James Wilder, formerly of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, University of Missouri, wearing the same number. Trying to emulate the old man with the running.
First down and 10 at the 39 for Geno Smith. And Smith up the sideline, almost picked off again. Jared Milo had two hands on the football. That would have been the third interception of the night, of the season for Smith.
And I think what we're seeing is the difference in confidence in attacking receivers. West Virginia's defensive backs don't have the confidence to attack Kansas State's receivers, and they're letting them run free. Kansas State has the confidence to attack maybe the best receiving corps in the nation with no worries.
Second and 10, Smith finds Austin, wrapped up by Arthur Brown.
First pass is to Austin. Arthur Brown.
And this is important for Geno Smith for a number of reasons. Not just, you know, you look at the scoreboard and that's very difficult, but showing your team that as the leader, you're staying in it, fully engaged, giving your best efforts. It's a very important sign to show.
Here's a screen pass, Garrison. And a first down and more. And that's a very interesting point you bring up. It reminds me of Jim Kelly with the Buffalo Bills. In all those Super Bowls, the four that he lost, he never gave up.
Never. And you never show people that. And you know what else? There's also a bunch of people here for the next level evaluating. They want to see how you're going to react in the most adverse conditions possible. This is an opportunity for him to show his moxie, to show his will.
First down, Smith underneath. And caught, Copeland. He gets out of bounds.
I checked the list and I saw, I think, four or five different teams from the NFL here to take a look tonight. They'll be filing reports on how guys handle things when the chips are really down.
First down and 10 now for West Virginia at the 34. Smith hands it off. Bowie. By the Tui with the tackle.
Last year they were pretty much an iron group inside, not much depth in terms of defensive line. Talk about Kansas State, but this season I'm seeing more guys rolling in and getting more playing time, building that depth inside. Less plays usually equals more production for defensive linemen.
Smith scrambling, and Smith out of bounds at the 30. This time it's Randall Evans knocking him out of bounds. This Kansas State defense so tough. Fundamentally superior, the offense as well. And you just look at their schedule, Charles, and you say to yourself, after winning here at West Virginia, if they're able to hold on and win, Texas Tech at home, Oklahoma State at home, at TCU, at Baylor, home against Texas. Could they run the table? Big question. Right now, though, they're happy with a 52-7 lead. 52-7 to start the fourth quarter. Geno Smith and West Virginia looking for some kind of momentum, some kind of spark, something to build on. Now Smith decides to run. And Smith going out of bounds. Justin Tuggle chasing him out of bounds. Brings up fourth down and four.
You know, as people look for the small things as we go on, I thought I saw something on that play. You know what it was? As he got to the sideline, he could have just gone over. You know what he did? You see him take that little hop step to try and get a couple yards at the end? Still competing. That's what you want to see out of him.
Fourth down and four. West Virginia going forward. Underneath, looking for the first down. And they will get it. Stedman Bailey. Yards after the catch. Some impressive running as he gained seven on fourth and four.
That was, wasn't it? Ducking inside into the teeth of the defense right in the middle. The former West Virginia coach Art Pappy Lewis used to call that the Briar Patch. Who'll stick their face in the Briar Patch? Stephen Bailey just did.
First down. Smith. And he sacked. Fourth sack of the evening. This time it's Adam Davis for Kansas State. Now let's go to Aaron Andrews for a game break.
Gus, you may want to have your partner look away right here. Alabama in Knoxville. A.J. McCarron finding Amari Cooper, 42-yard touchdown pass. He has seven catches, 163 yards, two touchdowns. Roll Tide, 30-10 over your Vols, Charles Davis. Sorry.
I appreciate your sympathy, Aaron. All I'm going to say is that while the kid was in school, 4-1 against Alabama. Yes, a fifth year because of my red shirt year, and I'm counting it. 4-1 against Alabama.
Long time ago, Charles Davis.
Yeah, but that's all I got, baby.
52-7. Fox College Football is sponsored by the Buick Verano. Unexpected luxury in a car this size. By DirecTV. Don't just watch TV, DirecTV. And by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. Welcome back, 52-7. Fourth-ranked Kansas State on top of West Virginia here on the road. Geno Smith facing a second and 16. At the K-State 27, Smith underneath, ball caught by J.D. Woods inside the 20, gain of 9, and Smith wincing a bit, limping a bit, kind of got rolled over two plays ago. But continues to play, third down and 7 of the 18. Play fake, Smith gunning it, and incomplete. Intended for McCartney, but Nigel Malone was there defensively for Kansas State. First red zone possession this evening. So surprising for a team that averages 543 yards of total offense per game, sixth in the nation. 385 yards passing. Fourth down and 7. Smith to the sideline. Incomplete, and West Virginia turns it over on downs. Kansas State not giving West Virginia any daylight. Here comes Colin Klein after this. All right, here's a look at the BCS top 10 and how some of the teams fared today.
Take a look. Alabama, of course, holding serve in Knoxville. Florida with a big win over number 7 South Carolina. Oregon Thursday night. Mashed Arizona State. Those 43 points, they scored them all in the first half. We're seeing what Kansas State's doing tonight. Notre Dame squeaks by BYU. LSU, a very good win at Texas A&M. USC pounding Colorado today. I think they're going to move up into the top 9 in the country. A little bit of shakeup in the top 10, not a lot, but it's going to make you think about your voting with how some of these teams won today.
John Hubert running, and you're a voter, so I'm going to put you on the spot. At Charles Davis, the hashtag.
SCD.
You look at what Kansas State has done on the road.
Number 13 team in the country they're beating.
So how do you vote this
makes,
week?
Makes me
they're number
think.
Four. What do you do?
I'm sitting here thinking this is about as impressive a win as I've seen. Could they be a team that you would candidate for number one in the country? That's how impressive this has been tonight. I'll be thinking about it before I cast my vote later this evening.
Thinking of speaking of tweets, and this is Tony Dungy. Maybe the most impressive college football performance today. They are destroying West Virginia in Morgantown. And that's Tony Dungy, Super Bowl winning coach, one of the great defensive minds in the history of the game. And I would agree with him.
I mean, it's just been top to bottom, save one kickoff return given up. It's been about as close to perfect as we've seen in all aspects.
We know our Jimmy Johnson and Terry Bradshaw are sitting at a hotel right now. First sack of the night for West Virginia. I know Coach Dungy, Coach Johnson, and Terry Bradshaw are sitting there watching this game, probably feeling the same way. Go to Aaron Andrews for another game break.
We're all sitting back there feeling the same way as well. Let me update you on Georgia at Kentucky. They're down by one. Aaron Murray, 22-yard touchdown pass to Chris Conley. Georgia finally taking the lead in this one, 22-17, guys.
Aaron, give Kentucky some credit. Everything seems to be crumbling there, and they're trying to get off the deck and fight for their head coach, Joker Phillips.
First punt of the evening for Ryan Doerr. A fair caught by Tavon Austin. 10:27 to play in the fourth quarter. 52-7, K-State. Next Saturday, Fox College Football presented by Geico rolls into Manhattan, Kansas to watch these Kansas State Wildcats take on the Texas Tech Red Raiders in another crucial Big 12 showdown. It all starts with the Fox College Saturday pregame show at 3 p.m. Eastern, 12 Pacific. How about Texas Tech winning in overtime at TCU, 56-53. Red Raiders now 3-1 in the Big 12, 6-1 overall. And as you mentioned, they're playing much better defense this year under Tommy Tuberville.
Are you ready to do the Daigie? Because Seth
yes.
Daigie the last 2 weeks has thrown 6 touchdown passes last week, 7 this week. And now we look at the Big 12 standings overall. Kansas State, one of the few teams in the conference with 5 road games in conference this year, handling things and leading as we continue to move into the season.
Geno Smith. And this is Stedman Bailey with the reception in front of Nigel Malone. Coming into the season, the Big 12 media poll had Oklahoma as the team predicted to win the Big 12, followed by West Virginia, Texas, Oklahoma State. Kansas State was picked to finish 6th.
And you know something, we make that mistake with them every year, don't we?
They weren't even ranked last year. Now preseason and finished 10-3, went to the Cotton Bowl.
But you know what they don't like? They don't like being picked high. I mean, when you pick Kansas State to win it or pick them number 2, that just doesn't seem to agree with them very much. They love coming off the pace.
Here's Smith. Incomplete. As he overthrows his receiver, Devontae Robinson.
And what I've been most impressed with Kansas State's secondary today is the number of plays on the football that they make. You know, you talked about it earlier, Gus, about their ability to tackle on the spot. Also coverage. When the ball's delivered, they're there.
And Bowie picks up the first down as he gets to the K-State 21. Jared Milo with the tackle.
Jared Milo is a walk-on who was a junior college transfer who came to Kansas State, earned a starting job. His brother, Brian Goolsby, is a former Kansas State fullback.
A lot of legacy players on this Kansas State team. handoff. That's in the 20. Arthur Brown with the tackle.
They call him the judge. You see why. You know, there's no jury needed when he's around. He's going to render a decision with his pads and finish things off.
Second down and 8. Bailey. And I guess if you're West Virginia at this time, the most important thing is to keep working.
Have to. They've got so much schedule left. And yes, they were picked second, as you noted in the preseason poll, and they were high flying earlier this year. But these last few weeks, they've been grounded a bit. All right, last couple of weeks with Texas Tech and now here by Kansas State. They've got to find a way to move the football, obviously offensively, the way they used to, but somehow, some way on defense, contain people a little bit.
Bowie again. And Bowie gets to the 5. If you take a look at the West Virginia schedule, next week they have TCU at home, then a trip to Stillwater. And the Sooners come into Morgantown.
Oh, what a stretch there. They don't have anything easy over the next 3 weeks. TCU could have very easily have won the Texas Tech game today.
Davon Austin, touchdown, West Virginia. Their first offensive touchdown this evening. So with 7 minutes and 31 seconds remaining in the fourth. Extra point up is good, 52-14. But it's been a great night for Colin Klein. He's done everything you could ask of a quarterback, and he may have gotten in the Heisman Trophy, the top of the Heisman Trophy list. Fox College Football is sponsored by AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. 52-14, not as many push-ups as they'd like tonight here in West Virginia. And our Hankook Tire performance of the game, Colin Klein with some career highs.
I mean, 7 total touchdowns, 3 touchdown passes, which is a career high. First game ever with 300 or more yards passing by Colin Klein. Would he run in 4? Ran in 4 also tonight. Not much he did not do, and I would think that that should be it for him tonight. You know, you got a lot left in this season and a lot of goals to accomplish, not just him getting a Heisman Trophy, but this is a team that's squarely in the chase for a national championship.
Lockett from the 10. And Lockett gets to the 43 of West Virginia. Time now for our Reese's perfect play, and it's Colin Klein.
Look at this throw into double coverage, interfered with on the play. And look at Chris Harper using his 235 pounds and muscle to fight for the football and come up with it for the perfect play.
Can Colin Klein be a pro?
I think he can definitely be a pro. Now, the key is he a pro quarterback? That's where the fight's going to come in. The same fight that Tebow's had, although more people, I think, were sold on Tebow coming out as a quarterback. But Colin Klein's making a statement that you're going to have to evaluate him as a quarterback first, not as an athlete first.
Now Daniel Sams comes in, the backup QB. Redshirt freshman out of Slidell, Louisiana. Coming in for Colin Klein. Here's Aaron Andrews with the game break.
Texas starting to pull away from Baylor, guys. Joe Bergeron, 4-yard touchdown run. His 4th touchdown of the game. That would put Texas up 42-28. It's now 42-31 at the half.
Boy. It's a halftime score. 42-31. My goodness.
Second down and 2 to 34 for Kansas State. Sands. Wants to run it. And wrestled down. Jared Barber sophomore, with the tackle.
Gus, you want a little career advice?
Yes.
If someone comes to you and says, I want you to be a defensive coordinator in the Big 12,
pass.
You tell them no.
I would agree with you, sir. As a matter of fact, you could say that for all of college football nowadays. Third down and 6 at the 38. Daniel Sams will throw it for the first time. And complete. Went on the money and a first down. Miller with the reception. So Sams, as a senior at Salmon High School, where his team was ranked number one in the state of Louisiana, he turned in one of the most versatile seasons of any player in the nation, passing for 577 yards and 7 touchdowns, rushing for 579 yards and 9 scores, and catching 21 passes for 518 yards and 9 more scores. Along with his punt and kickoff return yardage, he amassed over 3,000 all-purpose yards. Here's a handoff, and it's Robinson with the tackle. So let's take a look at some of the schedules of the top teams in America. We'll start with the Florida Gators, who defeated South Carolina today.
So they have Georgia and Jacksonville, their traditional battle, and that's one that both need, obviously. Missouri, Lafayette, Jacksonville State, they should be fine there. Florida State to finish up. Oregon, the USC game looms at USC. And then they still have Stanford and Oregon State finishing that Civil War on the road. Kansas State.
We will come back after this play. Second and 11. Sams hands it off. Robinson straight ahead.
And now with Kansas State, remember, 5 road games in the Big 12. Not many teams have that. Okay, Texas Tech next week, that should be a mammoth game. Oklahoma State, they get them at home again, another one that's big time. TCU could have very easily won today against Texas Tech. Baylor, we see the kind of numbers they're putting up today against Texas, and then of course they finish with Texas. And one thing about Kansas State, they've been Texas's kryptonite over the years. You know, Texas had some really good teams, and Kansas State has beaten them many, many times.
Third down at 7. At the 25, Sams to throw it. Up top. Broken up.
I like that though, Nana Kyrum making the play on the corner. And what I like about it most of all, what have I been saying all night? The Kansas State's defensive backs will challenge you for the football. They make plays on the ball. West Virginia's have not done that very much tonight. I like seeing the young freshman. Kyrum making a play on the ball and challenging a receiver.
So Anthony Cantelli comes in to attempt a 42-yard field goal. Good from 33 this evening. This one looks pretty good as well, and it is. 55 now, 14. 3:48 to play in the fourth quarter in Morgantown. Busy day for the Wildcat. He's got to go all the way down, though, Charles. That's a half a push-up.
Yeah, if we're going to quibble tonight, we got to talk to Willie about his form. You know what I think, though? I think his head gets in the way. Because I think the nose touches, and that just pushes him back up.
So here come the Mountaineers, starting from the 10. And it's Jordan Thompson stumbling forward. Tomorrow, Foxtoberfest continues with Fox NFL Sunday as the Redskins battle the Giants or other regional action. Tomorrow night, though, it's game 6 of the NLCS as the Cardinals once again look to clinch the pennant while the Giants try to force a decisive game 7. No need to leave your couch all month long. Foxtoberfest is here. San Francisco bouncing back last night. Larry Zito with a terrific performance on the mound. Big lefty.
And Carpenter wants to try and get right. His last appearance wasn't what he normally puts out there. And who do they play in the World Series, the winner of that?
The American League champion, Detroit Tigers.
That's right, I almost
forgot. With Jason the Highlander Verlander, there can only be one.
And is there a triple crown winner or something over there?
Yeah, there's another guy, you know, big guy, Cabrera. He plays, he's okay. My mother even called me about that.
Representing the hometown.
That's right. She had a lot to say about the Yankees.
In the name of Gates Brown, the Tigers are back in the World Series.
Willie Horton, second and three. And a new quarterback in the game for West Virginia, Paul Miller. Miller from Flower Mound, Texas. Last season, he was 7 of 15 for 124 yards, a touchdown, and two interceptions. He's played in three games this year. Geno Smith, this is one that he'll think about for quite some time.
And I think it's an overall team has to think about it for quite some time. You made the point earlier, Gus. It wasn't just, you know, offense. It wasn't just defense. It was the whole system having a very tough evening. He'll take the brunt of it because he's the quarterback. But they really didn't have much of a chance. Even though they weren't running much offense, that score just kept mounting, and now you're totally out of your rhythm in your game.
So from what you've seen, what has happened over the last 2 weeks with West Virginia?
Well, defensively, they just don't hold up at all. So now your offense is in a position where you got to just deal with what is good, what is happening. How about this for the defense? The last two games, they've given up 1,171 yards and 118 points in the last two games. So when you're dealing with that offensively, you could be a juggernaut, and you almost feel like you're playing from behind all the time.
Well, where do you start if you're Dana Holgorsen?
Well, I think you've got to talk about what you're doing defensively. You know, he said this week that it's not scheme, that they have to make plays. But I think the kids' confidence level is so low right now that even when they're in position to make plays, they don't pull the trigger and make them because they're worried about making mistakes. And when you're worried about making mistakes, guess what you do? You make more mistakes. And I think that's what's happened to them. They may have to talk about trying to do a little bit more of a contained defense than being as aggressive as they've been.
Well, we know that this is West Virginia's first year in the Big 12, Big East champions a year ago. Is the talent level and the competition in this conference that much better than in the Big East?
It is. It is. Because in the Big East, West Virginia ruled the block. I mean, they walked in, and every time they walked into a field, they had at least as good a talent as who they're playing. Usually they had better talent. This year, you're seeing the Big East play pretty well overall, though. Cincinnati's undefeated. You know, they were undefeated going into today. Rutgers stayed undefeated today, I know. And, of course, Louisville, who's really, to me, the front runner with Charlie Strong and his team. But top to bottom, the Big 12 versus the Big East, I don't think there's a comparison. And West Virginia's got to go through a few of those growing pains as they go through it.
First down and 10, 47 seconds remaining in this football game. Miller will throw it. Incomplete, flag on the play. Pass interference coming up against West Virginia. Excuse me, against Kansas State. Kip Daly, Devontae Robinson, the intended receiver.
Robinson's a true freshman. They just took the red shirt off of to get him on the field
tonight.
Pass
interference, defense number 7, be a 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Andrew Player on the field, 37 seconds to go. Back to Morgantown after this. ...55-14 Kansas State with the lead, 37 seconds remaining. There's a injured West Virginia player on the field. It's the right guard, Jeff Braun.
Can ill afford to lose him. He came into tonight, 32 starts in his career, most of them at guard, although he played right tackle in 2010. Hurt an ankle at Texas Tech. They weren't sure he'd be able to go tonight, and he made the start.
Good sign to see him walking off on his own as we take a look at what happened.
To the right side of your screen, in the middle of your screen there. There's Braun, 57, and he ends up getting rolled up on number 98, Shaquille Reed for Kansas State, inadvertently rolling on to Jeff Braun. Hope that he's going to be okay.
So Braun being helped off the field. West Virginia with the football at the Kansas State 19. Millard in for Geno Smith, the backup quarterback. Miller will throw it. Sideline. Knocked down. Campbell, the intended receiver. And this Kansas State secondary has played oh so well this game. Zach McFaul defensively.
You see that? Going home may not be the best recipe. Teams are 4-12 in the Big 12 at home this season, counting tonight. Can you imagine that? Remember when home meant you just handled things? On the road, people are going in there and beating people in the Big 12, and Kansas State goes home for Texas Tech next week. That's not a graphic they want to see.
Could be the final play of the game. Miller gets it away, hands it off. And that's it. Garrison with the run. Colin Klein, what a game. 19 of 21, 323 yards, 3 passing touchdowns. He also rushed for 4 touchdowns, and Bill Snyder comes into Morgantown. And his Wildcats.